The Babylonians had believed Nabu to be a god of wisdom. He was already, in his own way, a champion of order. Willing to defy his father, Marduk, Chaos's immortal mortal ally upon the Earth. What better candidate for Order's purpose? So the Lords of Order recruited Nabu's soul, now free of the limitations of his fragile mortal form. Elevating it to a higher calling, they gave purpose to his once pointless death and revealed the dangers resulting from the chaos of the Clarion-Marduk Alliance. Gaining an oath of Nabu's fealty to Order, the Lords forged something new. Not simply an agent of Order on Earth, but a Lord of Order, created from the soul of mortal man. And Nabu's own helmet, the Helmet of Fate, would act as the anchor for his spirit on the mortal plane. The only thing required was a human host body capable of channeling Nabu's mystic power. Such hosts were not always easy to come by. Yet Nabu became the Lord of Order, known as Dr. Fate, who has for centuries defended this world from chaos. And thus a single champion was raised by Order to battle chaos in all its forms.
Nabu, why do you tell me what I already know?
So that you may understand why there is as yet no need for us to act. Let the Chaos Lords fight until even the victor has been weakened by battle. Fate will step forward to bring order in the end, as we have done for millennia.
Nabu, how can you miss the point of your own story? You view Fate as a single champion, a lone warrior, capable of triumphing over any opposition. But this has never been true, nor was it your master's intent. The Lords of Order planned for Dr. Fate's formation to require two champions, Nabu and Fate's host. Both are equally important, for if the host fails, so falls Fate. And for Fate to succeed, Nabu must draw on his host's diverse strengths. Yet every host, every person, finds their strength in their own way. Look at these three children whom you tested this day. Finding strength through mentors, family, and faith. Honestly, do you think I would have survived these 10 years as your host and prisoner without my faith in a higher power? Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done. On earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Amen. And the victories you so proudly cite, would they have come without allies such as the League or the Lords of Order themselves? You view cooperation as chaos, but it is only in the combined strengths of all these individuals, in the unity of the disparate, that order may truly rise out of chaos. You must know this on some level, or why else would you have allowed Kent Nelson to push you into joining the Justice Society, or allowed me to keep you in the Justice League? Great Nabu, step back from the precipice of your own arrogance and heed the words of those who seek only to aid your cause, lest you fall victim to chaos as you did in your natural life so many years ago. Start by listening to my daughter.